different paintings. Girls, quiet down, please. Three different paintings of Saint Sebastian done by three different artists. Now, in this first one, you will notice it has a more
I was pretty young, 10 or 11, I guess, when I discovered that I loved the beauty of watching men in pain.
Halfway through this seat race now, and you are even. You are called to JV crew, but you are even. We're taking it with consistency. We're taking it by working together. And grab the legs now. Drive together.
Stone! Look ahead more often! You can't throw and hope!
Don't let that pussy whip you, Sheila! You're the stroke, baby! You're the
swing away.
Let me hear your cotton speech!
Born at sea, baptized in blood! Crowned with victory!
Buster! Harder! Meaner!
Born at sea, baptized in blood! Crowned with victory!
Tiff.
Yeah.
Final power 20.
His name was Tiff. Christopher, really, but when he was little, he couldn't get his tongue around it, so he called himself Tiffer. Tiff, for short.
I got something for you. Lie down, exercise.
Man is an inferior creature born to serve woman. The agony he experiences at her hands is but the purest pleasure for them both. For while she knows the limits of his suffering, his trust in her is servile and profound.
You and your women's lib shit.
A guy wrote that tip. Soccer may suck. You might try reading a book sometime.
Any day now, kids!
Shut up, stoner! Count down from bow when ready!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
All 8 ready to row! Row!
Tiff was a masterpiece of pain, and I had a front row seat. 1975, our last year at Harvard. Back in the 70s, rowing was just a sport for preppies. It wasn't a power sport like football or track. The only fans who watched it were the rowers' relatives and friends. The media ignored rowing, so did the agents, and anybody else interested in making money out of sports.
Let's do another power 20.
Another power 20, let's go!
Harry Parker was murderously competitive. Till he came along, American rowers practiced March through June. Harry whipped those Harvard boys into practicing year-round. When they started beating everybody else, all the other schools started practicing year-round, too. Madness begot madness.
New chapter.
Careful, please, with my scam on. It takes me six fucking years of my life to get it back here.
Come on, man.
Let's go.
What's up, Tiff?
What's going on, man?
Slim finally got her husband's skull back.
Oh, from where?
It's Germany.
Ah, you have one of these for the stay.
Oh, God! Do
everything for you guys?
Ah, thank God. I need your help.
Tip, come here. On your knees, my slave.
Come on, Tip, let's
That's
go.
It. Thanks, good boy.
You look pretty good for Bow. Okay. Sit down, man. Let's go.
Refills?
Cat, what's this? Huh? I never really pictured you as religious.
Now, who said I was? Just like the idea of a god who suffers.
Pain's Cat's religion.
Yours too.
Yeah, but he doesn't talk about it.
None of you do.
Part of the code. The code.
Oh, yeah, right, the code. Guys start talking about the code, I want to reach for my Tampax.
Thank you. Talking about it only makes it worse.
Not talking about it makes it unendurable.
And we felt it when?
Just for strokes.
She bites.
Give you guys something to talk about.
Bites.
That, my friend, is top American single sculler. He went to Munich in 72, and he's still driving around in his beat-up 64 VW.
That's a piece of work.
Bert used to say, nothing better than double skull. Not love, not wine, not even sex. Only double let two people become one. Sloppy is German romanticism. He was scared of single skull, that's all. Frightened to be alone. Americans have no problem with alone, I think.
It comes naturally for us.
Bert always say, master the double, you swing through the single.
What?
Conquer the double. Rowing single, no problem. But never other way around. You start with single. Big American ego never want double.
We won the four-miler against Yale that year. 13 years in a row, we stripped the t-shirts right off their Yaley backs. So after the race, when Sheely said to Harry, are we or are we not the greatest crew you ever coached? All Harry said was, that was a well-rowed race. So you rode crew, too.
Yes, I was spare, some for the eight, some 40 years ago.
Well, you still look pretty fit, and you're a Leander man, too, I see.
Yeah, and I'm still waiting to get in the boat. The others are so fit that I'm still the spare.
My life, Sherlock.
After graduation?
Yep, I'm gonna play Monopoly.
Oh, not Wall Street.
Sure, why not?
You gonna give up rowing? Oh, no, Al, we're ripe for the 1980 Olympics. We're gonna roll the double.
Fuck the double. Fuck Moscow. Tiff, rowing is never going to be a big money sport. And I want to make some money, and I want to have a life.
Yeah, as a money-hungry stiff in a three-piece suit.
Well, I can't afford to be an amateur anymore.
You think I can? You think Stone can?
Come on. Your dads are loaded. You guys could be amateurs a long time.
Couldn't ask my father.
Why the fuck not? What, is he going to miss the odd grant?
I wouldn't feel right about it.
Well, I would. Oh, no, really, I would, man. Wait, I'm too broke for scruples.
Well, then maybe you should ask him to be your sugar daddy.
Maybe I should, Tiff, because one of us has got to stick to the river.
Hey, Stone.
Oh, yeah.
If you got the time, you want to improve?
Improve? Improve? Sure, if I can.
Christ.
I knew it was you. The last of the rude and smooth.
Ah, no. He's rude. I happen to be very smooth these days.
Uh-huh.
You're looking fine.
Thanks.
How's New York?
Shitty. 12 interns. I'm the only chick.
Sounds kind of like her, see?
They're all jocks, too.
On a sports magazine, Kat, this is not surprising.
Not even real jocks. Jock wannabes. But I got out of it what I wanted to get out of it.
Kate Bordelot.
Deep and penetrating oriental massage.
New England stringer.
Light bondage.
Sports monthly.
Do you do golden showers? Not enough girls do golden showers.
Such a jerk.
Kate?
It's my name, Christopher.
Oh! Ah!
Ah, yes, Christopher. Kate has obviously entered the world of people with real jobs and real money.
Sorry.
Oh, it isn't.
Sorry, I didn't mean to
throw
you off.
No, you really know how to make a guy choke.
Slow you down. It is a race to you, isn't it?
Well, everything's a race. I mean, climbing the stairs, brushing your teeth, walking. You'll see how quickly you can make it to the end.
I didn't mean to criticize you.
Same when I was little. I like new toys. I don't know what to do with them. The same thing with a new skull.
Or a new girl. Thanks.
Well, what about you?
What about?
Alone.
That's funny. It sure felt like it.
Thank you.
You think I'm such a bitch I would try and humiliate you?
Man was born to serve woman. And the pain he experiences at her hands is the most exquisite pleasure for them both. Sasha.
All we need is a little practice. It'll come.
Maybe Coach Parker could come by and give us some tips. He could stand at the edge of the bed, give me a power 10, give me a power 20.
When Stone and I first took out the double, I was awkward as hell.
Would you quit comparing me to a fucking boat?
All I meant to say was that after we had some time to get used to it, that double was a smooth machine.
Look, all that's happened here is we finally got around to doing something that we should have done years ago, and it didn't work out. It puts us back at square one. That's all. Friends. We're friends. Okay?
Okay.
In 1977, Tiff and Stone were ready for the national double trials. But Tiff got sick as a dog and they couldn't race. That was the beginning of the end of their double. After that, Stone wanted to move on to the single.
Scholars for the Olympics.
Good morning to you too, young man.
Hi.
They've asked me to.
Well, what are you gonna coach?
Well, I told them I want everything. Sweeps, sculls, and the Harvard team.
They gonna give it to you?
You're not practicing today?
No. Stone's parents are up from Vermont. He ran out of money, so he's hitting him up for a long.
Well, that's the doubles for you. Sneeze, your partner catches cold. That's just the way it is.
That why you always rode the single?
Maybe. Not really.
Well, why'd you rode the single?
Well, win or lose, you're the only one to blame.
Looks like they shot from the footage. The
what footage?
60s, Olympics. Sheely dug it up for us. We wanted to see you. I'm gonna lose. Harry.
Why don't you give her a try?
You mean it?
Great mist.
With Soviet invading forces in Afghanistan, neither the American people nor I will support sending an Olympic team to Moscow.
It's hard to understand. The Olympics are supposed to be non-political. We've all worked so hard for this that the president's decision feels like a real setback. The president hasn't made a real choice of political necessity. It is unfortunate that this boycott affects such a non-political event as the Olympics. The Olympics have always been a celebration of amateurism and the true spirit of sportsmanship. But I know that of all the American athletes,
let's go.
Should this be non-political or apolitical?
Non-political.
Needs to be strong.
Shut up, Stone. You know what you're talking about.
It's hard to understand.
I understand the U.S. rowing team has taken a very strong stance against the Olympic boycott.
All athletes should take a strong stance against the U.S. boycott. The Olympics are supposed to be...
Are you criticizing other athletes for supporting the president's boycott?
If they truly believed in amateurism, then they'd take the strongest stance possible. Look, we've all been training for years for the Olympics. Now, keeping us home isn't going to change anything in Afghanistan. Jimmy Carter is using us. We're pawns in his political game, and the only one who's going to get hurt in this boycott is us. Now, Jimmy Carter is sending an entire generation of athletes to an early retirement. And I can't believe that little peanut farmer is going to come
off. Come on.
I is going to have the shot. It's going to be me who's going to decide when our tires is out.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is obviously an emotional issue for all of us. It's very important that you listen to what we have to say today. And maybe we can get something done about this.
Глэр не смогли сегодня повторить свой успех и взять еще одно золото. У них только бронза. А первое место и золотую медаль Московской Олимпиады завоевал финский спортсмен Перти Карпинен. Наш Василий Ягуша был вторым, уступив чемпиону лишь 2 секунды. Его время 7 минут 11,66 секунды. И на третьем месте Петр.
You look so good.
Oh, thanks. I feel like shit. Got the early bird out of Atlanta. I still ended up stacked up over Kennedy for 2 hours.
New England was your beat.
The world's my beat, baby.
All right, tell me all about Beantown.
Hardly ever there. Tiff seems to be settling in, though. Mm. Aldo, martini straight up, extra olives. Thanks.
Si, senor.
I think it's the perfect job for him, though, Sheely. They're remarkably understanding about the time he gives to the river.
Sure, they're all Harvard boys, after all.
Yeah.
Tiff's never to know that I set it up.
Yeah, yeah, Scott's on her.
Anyway, he's got the job, he's got the practice time, and he's set for the 84 Olympics. God, that must feel so good.
A lot can change in 3 years. What happens in 84 when he goes up against 20-year-olds?
A lot of fresh blood out there, huh?
Mm-hmm. Whole new generation of rowers coming out of Yale. Very fine talent.
Kids who beat Harry Parker's team on the New York sprint a couple of years ago.
Yeah, first time Harvard's lost to Yale in 16 years. A couple of these guys are real sharks, too. John Biglow, Joe Bouscaren. Thank you, Aldo.
You know, Kate, maybe what Tiff needs is a little fresh blood. Get him going again.
I can make it through the kitchen. I can make it through the toothbrush. I can make it through the kitchen.
I can make it to the front door. And I can make it to the car. One wreck salutes another.
I come and one go home. Tommy cross the water like a big tarantula. Daylight come and one go home.
That's very inspiring. Oh, thank you.
Wait a second, Tiff.
Yeah?
We met a long time ago.
I row at Yale. My name's John Biglow.
It was head of the Charles, 1979. You won the single and I won in the eights.
Right. You guys beat Parker's crew.
That we did. Listen, what are you doing this morning?
2 minute pieces with equal rest.
You think,
yeah.
This is stupid. I just started singles. You think maybe I could work out with you? I won't get in your way.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
You almost beat me.
What's that?
You almost beat me.
I did beat you 2 out of 3 times there at the end.
Whatever.
This might be a stupid question, but why do you row, Tiff?
I like the speed.
Oh, yeah. 15 miles an hour really puts a part in your hair, huh?
You know when you row through all the pain and the boat just lifts right out of the water? It's like flying. Swing.
Hey, Tiff.
Hi.
Biggie.
Miss Bordello.
You guys know each other?
Yeah. I did a piece on his muscles for a magazine coming out next month. Did you know that Biggie here has the highest percentage of slow twitch muscles of all top American rowers? That's why he never gets tired. He's the slow twitch Hulk.
Oh, that was the title of the article.
No. Great endurance, no pain.
Biggie, come on, man. I've been waiting for you.
What for?
Well, I thought you needed a ride.
Oh, right. Joe, this is Tiff Wood. Tiff Wood, Joe Bouscaren.
Yeah, I know who he is. How you doing?
Good. Listen, Joe, Tiff and I are going to be training together from here on out. You care to join us?
No, thanks.
No?
No.
Why not?
You know why, Biggie.
Oh. Yeah, but Tiff doesn't.
I'm in medical school right now, so it's kind of hard to make definite, you know, times to train and stuff. You know, I don't know when I'm going to have to run off to the hospital. Or... Anyway, let's get going, because I got things to do and, you know.
Listen, why don't you go on ahead?
I can give you a lift, John.
Thanks.
Oh, okay, well, nice to meet you, Tiff.
Sorry, Grandmother, of course.
I'm so happy you could come, Tim.
Thank you, Mrs. Biglow. John tells me you've been a rowing supporter for a number of years.
Lean this way a little, dear, so you're in the light. I've been a big fan of yours for I don't know how long.
Thank you.
Goodness, now that's a rower's arm. John, have you felt that arm?
I am familiar with Tiff's musculature, Grandmother.
It's splendid, isn't it?
Oh, it's remarkable, given its age.
Yeah, we're gonna be celebrating your 91st soon, aren't we, Tiff?
Joe, why don't you tell Grandmother about your plan to win the Olympics?
What event, young man? Eights?
Oh, no, not the eights, Grandmother, or the quads. Joe just gets lost in them.
The double.
The double could be nice.
Surely not the single.
The single would be very nice.
You can't row the single.
I can't?
Of course not. That's for my John. Everyone knows that.
Everyone.
Mrs. Biglow, your grandson and Joe are going to kill each other. They're sharks.
Are you for the double then, dear?
Oh, I'm afraid I'm a shark too, Mrs. Biglow.
Seems to me you have the requisite elegance for the double. The very best of rowing. To all the sharks, then. To all my pretty sharks.
What is this?
Oh, it's my own celebration.
Clear the runway. Look at the side of this kid.
I'd invite you in, but I gotta get it.
An early morning? Yeah, well, I do too. So, some other time.
Yep. Then.
Too hard. Lactic acid'll build up and I'll burn out. Muscles won't contract. Biglow's fucking slow twitch never burns out. It isn't fair.
Stroke for stroke. I'm not getting old. I'm not old. I'm in better shape
kind
now
of thrill
than
you'll
ever be.
Either surge ahead or fade away.
I'll beat you, Biglow.
Go ahead and
beat
me,
fucking Harvard prick. But spare me this pain.
One stroke at a time.
You're beating
one,
Biglow.
Stroke at a time.
I'm gonna blow you right off the fucking river. Go!
Tell me the truth, Harry. Tiff is too old to race. This is what you think, yes?
That's ridiculous. He's in better shape than he ever was. He was, what, maybe a quarter second behind? That's not old.
Tiff's fine.
Tiff's fine.
It wasn't that hard.
To think I was gonna congratulate you, you conceited pig.
Hey, Biggie. Good race.
Ah, thanks. It was a great race.
A tenth of a second is not that big of a deal, baby.
No, not because I won, but because Tiff and I rode a great race.
Hey, Tiff.
Hey.
Good.
Just one thing.
What's that?
From now on, you train by yourself.
Well, here's Colby, and that's Tiff.
Poor Tiff had such a long, hard season, and then all of a sudden, everything fell into place. From the American Olympic trials to the World Championships in West Germany, this guy could do no wrong.
Peter Michael Kolbeck, West Germany, Uwe Mund, East Germany, and Vasily Yakusha from the Soviet Union. And they are supposed to finish in this order, Kolbe, Mund, and Yakusha.
Where's your boy?
Here. They go out from the start fast, so fast that after the first 100 meters, Tiff can't even see them. Well, of course, you know, when you're rowing, you face backwards anyway, so it's difficult to see under the best of circumstances.
Of
course. The only thing that keeps him going is his sense that he is rowing well. 500 meters to go, Tiff looks over his shoulder and he can see Yakusha. That means Tiff and Yakusha are in a real race now. Now he's got 50 strokes to go and he could hear the crowd roar.
Is Madam finished?
No. Later.
Okay, so 50 strokes to go.
I see. The West Germans are going crazy because this American no one's ever heard of is about to clobber the big Russian bear.
Exactly. 30 strokes to go, Tiff surges ahead and beats Yakusha. He beats the guy that placed second at the Moscow Olympics in 1980.
It's gonna make a fabulous book. We'll go large format, of course. Cloth and paper. So many men, so few clothes.
You know, actually, I was thinking as a concept.
One thing. I think you need to broaden your scope.
Okay.
You're going off to the summer camp thing.
Training camp.
Whatever. Instead of just focusing on Tiff, you throw all these tender young egos into the pot. Turn up the heat. You don't want to miss out on that. And if your boy loses, then where will you be?
He's not gonna lose.
I know that. You know that. All I'm saying is, let's get the emotional dynamics, the roiling passions, a sort of crossfire group portrait with muscles. The older fellow, the crusty coat?
Harry Parker.
I see him as a Paul Newman type.
Really?
The rule with coffee table books, Kate, is to cast your net wide, appeal to as many audiences as possible.
Okay.
This is not just a sports book. It's a flesh book. Have you got a title?
It's silly, really.
I love it when you're coy, Kate.
Coy? You make me sound like something out of Jane Austen.
Wow. So what's the title then? You can tell me.
God's in Pain.
That's so fun.
Shut up, Al. You know, yesterday at Lake Casitas, Tiff rode through Mund at 750, through Ricardo Abera at 1500. Al, I'm telling you, he won with energy to burn.
How'd Biglow do?
He choked. Took fourth.
Sounds like you're still hanging in there, though.
Yeah, but it's clear to everyone that Tiff should go to the Olympics in the single.
Yeah, or it could mean that Tiff has peaked early.
No, it doesn't. Tiff's ageless.
Let them take me, and I dream my heart was so
free. Guys, head back to the boathouse.
Don't make me late for Harry.
Hear me, Biggie?
I had come just ain't natural to be so in need. And if I can't hold you, if I can't make love stay, you'll find me a river.
Damn! 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 Shit! Shit, I drive 5,000 miles and just smash my boat into a wall. I can't believe it. You're the best bowler.
My first priority is to coach the Harvard crew, but you new arrivals are welcome to store your skulls in this boathouse until the Olympic trials. After the single skull trial, some of you will be invited to my camp to compete for the team camp boats. From then on, I'll be your coach. Yes, young lady, you have a question?
Don't you think it's time to revamp the whole selection process?
No, what do you mean by that?
Well, choosing the top single sculler first, you give the impression that the team boat trials are a consolation prize.
Well, that's not true, is it? Anyway, the Olympic Committee has made its decision for this year. It's out of our hands.
Would you have ruled the same way if you were the committee?
This young lady over here is Kat Bordelot.
Kate, sir, thank you.
Kate is working on a book on rowing for the 1984 Olympics. Now, she did Cox for Harvard, so she knows whereof she speaks. Now, if anyone wants to work on a team boat, we can get started now. There's plenty of skulls to practice with. Because the truth is that there are only three, maybe four of you who are real contenders for the single. So the, Excuse me, miss. You looking for someone? Is she with someone here?
She's my assistant, Mr. Parker.
Oh, I see. Well, perhaps you'd better keep her locked up until the Olympic trials.
Well, I'm afraid I have to disagree with you, Mr. Parker.
About what?
Well, there are only two real contenders in this room for the singles. And you're looking at one of them.
Sir?
Paul Enquist, what do you say? Going for the double?
Yeah.
Biglow's your double partner.
I was his doubles partner, sir. That was last year when I was having trouble with my back. I couldn't concentrate on the single.
Oh, you two make a great double. What are you talking about?
Well, yeah, but Tiff and Joe would make a great double, too. I want to go for the single.
You see. Is there anyone here who wants to row with Paul? Well, looks like you'll have to wait till the single's settled, Paul, before you have a partner.
Cruise along and still be a winner in my heat. They just canceled each other out. Next race, they'll be too pooped to pop.
Too pooped to pop.
Tired.
Yeah.
the door. I can make it to the hallway. Healthy body's got it.
And out of bed. We're stuck here in this wretched flea bag, and polar bear's over there in the four-star resort with his little girlfriend.
Who's that garment bag anyway?
She's definitely not a garment bag. She's his kendo sensei. So he teaches them the zen of swordsmanship.
Yeah, right.
Oh, really? They believe that there's not much difference between a sword and an oar. It's just an extension of the body.
Well, she can show me how to use my oar any day of the week.
Kendo sensing my ass.
It's hard to put bullshit. Something down just because it's outside of your own personal experience.
Seriously,
yes. I know he's a little bit different, but his techniques have really got something.
Guess. The fact remains is that polar bear is a classic nutcase. No. I mean, you know what he uses to grease his seat railing?
What, KY?
Get me the butter. Get me the butter now.
No, he uses lard.
Frisco?
Yeah.
Why?
Maybe it's better for a tight little Japanese ass.
Oh, Mr. Pickford, must you be so fucking crude?
Great to hell, Mr. Pickford.
Oh, look who's here. How you feeling, Tip?
Great. Famished, actually. Is that place okay?
It's okay. But you got rid of the double turkey club. It's the only thing you don't have to dial 911 after you eat.
Could you recommend a good wine to go with that, Mr. Biglow?
Yeah. And he prances away like a stag. Soon he'll need a barf bag. Eating at that diner is a real drag. So have fun, Tiff.
Bon appétit.
Can I join you?
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm not interrupting anything?
No, it's fine.
Tess, come on, sit down.
Well, you look pretty good, all things considered.
I feel like shit. I feel like I'm walking on two hard-ons.
That good, huh?
Not bad.
Excuse me, could I get two cheeseburgers, large order fries, and a jumbo Pepsi?
What's your strategy for the finals?
Well, there isn't a rower alive who can come from behind and beat Biglow. So, if I can stay ahead of him by a length, by about the 500-meter mark.
You can hold him off, like you did today.
Two tough races back to back. Today you were fresh.
Well, you know why Biggie lost? Harry and I were working this out.
No. Well, he had a weak start.
No.
He put too much into the first stroke, threw
him
off.
By the third stroke, he was back
balance, but then, you know, he started rowing his own race after that.
He was more sure. He was the most confident of all you guys.
Yeah, you can be sure that he won't go off balance on the first stroke tomorrow. But, well, you have the advantage.
Why is that?
In the world of rowers, Tiff. You're the sentimental favorite.
Why don't you set up? I'm gonna check on Parker, see if he's gonna go through with this.
It'll clear.
Think so?
It'll be rough, but it'll clear.
You could put it off.
Put it off?
Give Tiff a chance to recover.
Would that be ethical, do you think?
I think you would call it off if Tiff weren't racing. You don't want to look like you're favoring a guy you've been coaching for 8 years.
In sports, as in everything else, the appearance of fairness is as important as fairness itself.
Tell me something, Joe. You think that the slow twitch is a dominant or a recessive gene?
Fuck if I know. But according to Darwinian logic, the more desirable gene would prevail.
So what, you think in 10 years my 72% slow twitch is gonna be peanuts?
It's probably already been surpassed by some 16-year-old who hasn't even picked up an aura yet.
Well, all the same, it proves that I'm still more genetically evolved than you are.
Thank you. Lane 2, back 1 inch. Thank you. Lane 3, fine. Lane 4,
smooth strokes now.
Back 1 foot.
Gotta have this race now. Come on now.
Back. Lane 5, back. Thank you. Lane 6, fine. I have alignment.
Lane 1. Prêt? Lane 2. Prêt? Lane 3. Prêt? Lane 4. Prêt? Lane 5. Prêt? Lane 6. Prêt? Êtes-vous prêt? Passez!
Stroke rate here, about 35 to 36 strokes per minute.
Why'd Tiff come out slow? He's hanging back. Is this his new strategy? Trying to throw me off? Uh-oh, you old fox.
That's room fucking pain. Command your body! You're rolling the wrong goddamn race!
Damn, you're down. Bouscaren, you're next. Biglow, you're nothing. But right now, I'm gonna take it easy.
Polar bear, it's not fair.
Oh, Christ is back! Strokes to go. Come on, come on! Six sets of ten. Come on! One! Two! Three!
Congratulations, man.
What? What? I won?
Fucking insulting. It's a good thing I'm not pea shy.
Find a shell for us. You can find a place in Boston for you and your assistant. You have 7 weeks to train before the Olympics.
Yes. That's it, man. That's it. Yeah. You and me. We'd win the double trials for sure.
I don't think so. We've got to go back to Harry's camp. That's the ethical way to do it.
Ethics? Ethics? I mean, what do ethics have to do with it? You want to go to the Olympics just as much as I do. We don't need Harry's Boy Scout camp to do that. You and me, man. You and me. You and me together.
I'm sorry. I was just thinking out loud. Look,
man, the camp begins too soon anyway. We need some time to get the stiffness out of our legs, but if we work together, we can set our own timetable. I know what's worrying you. It's my ego thing, right? But the way I've been so far, that's not me. You know how it is. I've had to pump myself into pure annihilating ego anger to win the singles. But now I can go back to being my own self. Listen, I know it's been a long road for you. And
I know how hard it is to take, but it's been a long road for me, too. Training alone, always being the outsider, never fitting in because of my mixed blood and everything. But I'm not gonna blow it now. Not now, not if we have a chance, and I think we do have a chance. We'd make a great team, Tiff.
I can't do it.
I just don't get you.
He's not here.
He's not with you.
Why isn't the sign on?
I tell everyone, go home. I feel like celebrating.
Celebrating?
At least, like, getting drunk. Okay. Romovich. This we drink. Only when things are very, very bad or very, very good. This is time I like most. You drink so much, the whole world seems clear. Only for a moment or two.
He lost. 8 years for this, and he lost.
So easily you enter his meat.
What's that supposed to mean?
His meat, his story. Of angry, rich American boys who only want to suffer alone. They pay fortune to suffer alone.
You think it's good he lost?
He's too old now to stay boy.
What's going on?
I wasn't particularly happy until I discovered rowing. My parents split. I was 13. Small. 13. So there was this rowing class, and I signed up. We went out in the water, and it was windy.
Cold, raining.
And the boat's filled with water. Everyone was driven off. Except me. I thought, now this is a sport I can excel at. Because it doesn't take grace or skill or timing, just strength, endurance.
Now it's all over. You can spend the rest of your life wondering why you lost to Biggie on the last stroke of the race.
Got any better ideas?
You could jump. Slim says there's a kind of splendor in defeat.
Slim's full of shit. So are you.
She says the one thing Americans never learn is that life is about losing. Or not.
Fuck off, Kate.
So, you want me to go to that camp?
Everybody else left for Harry's camp this morning. There's still the team boats to pick.
Oh, everybody?
Yes, Polar Bear too. I'm heading out this afternoon because I have a book to finish.
I guess I won't make the final chapters then, huh? Why don't you take a picture of this? Hey, the self-flagellation of Tiff Wood.
Fuck off.
We don't have much time. 7 weeks before the Olympic trials. We're going to assemble a fast double and a fast quad. That's all that my camp is sending to Lake Carnegie. First of all, we're going to concentrate on the double. The quad will remain on the back of the trailer for the time being. And every morning, you'll row 2,000 meters twice. After each race, the winning crew will stay together. The losers will be given new partners. That's the first 3 weeks. The fourth week, we pick the camp double. That's how we're going to proceed. Hmm, Biglow?
What?
Can I row the double with Tiff?
Funny guy.
All right, boys, settle down. And before you hit your assigned rooms, just one note about phone privileges.
Hey,
there are none. No phone calls to your girlfriends, no phone calls to your mother.
You
got that?
Man. Have fun with your new roommate, Tiff.
I have no tactics.
Now what, Biglow?
Do you want me to row the double? Make room for Tiff in the single?
Well, I did want Tiff to row the single in the Olympics, that's true.
So, where do we go from here?
Well, we got our answer to that when you won at Lake Carnegie.
Long enough. Stan, you're going out with Paul Enquist.
Thank you, sir.
Bruce Smith, help with that ball. Thank you.
This is ridiculous. I must have a knitting disability. Don't start. Don't start with me.
And I guess the most important thing you gotta remember is not to let it get too tight, because then you'll be, you know, gone. And the way to avoid that is keep the knitting down on the needles. So if it gets too close, if you keep knitting. Biglow, what the hell are you doing, man?
I think I got your tightness speech a little bit late.
Yeah, no, you gotta go up, through, and then around, then down through.
Excuse me, there's a draft.
Nelson, you're the stroke with Danny Pickford up against Bouscaren and Cruz.
Tiff's stroke's holding back the skulls. Let's face it, Harry, Tiff's a single sculler to the bone.
Well, I'm knitting an ego warmer for Joe here. Notice how it's full of holes.
Just like your head, John.
Are you okay?
I'm making a hat.
It's going along well.
But a hat? I was hoping
What are you doing? Hey, we got a stitch quiz in 10 minutes. You can't go in there.
I thought she was knitting one of those macrame bikinis they saw at Crane's Beach.
This isn't bad. I think I might be able to fix this.
Sounds too much like a conspiracy to me.
You know, even Harry thinks he's a flake. He should go back out west where he belongs.
Yeah, with the other surfers.
Yeah, but what about Tiff? I mean, he's one of us.
Well, the old order changes. Yielding place to the new.
He's a previous generation, previous Olympics. Should have retired years ago.
Oh, you hurt, man. Hurt.
We gotta get him to a hospital. Get his shoes.
Yeah. I'll take him. Come on. Let's go. What happened out there, Paul?
I tried to follow Tiff. I just raced up to the catch and pulled so hard, I just tore a muscle. It's my fault. 100% my fault.
Look good together.
Yeah, fucking love boat.
Got a minute?
Yeah.
I think Tiff's still worn out from the trials.
Oh, he's not the only role recovering from Carnegie.
He's the only one that you've been coaching for 8 years.
Well, this is the national team I'm coaching now, Kate.
You're Tiff's coach, Harry. I mean, you can't just turn your back on him.
Nelson? What is it?
I just want to know, how come you haven't paired me with Tiff? It just makes sense for us to roll the double.
And why do you think it makes sense?
because we finished second and third at Lake Carnegie.
You don't think we need any more Olympic trials? You think everything should have been settled at Lake Carnegie?
Sure, why not?
Because it just doesn't make sense, that's why.
Why can't you at least give us a chance?
Because that is not the way it's done.
Danny's gonna be the stroke. Bruce, you row a two-seat. Stan, you'll be bow. And Tiff, you're gonna row a three-seat with Danny, Bruce, and Stan.
Your quad?
That's right.
Woo-hoo! You got this right, baby! It's time to celebrate!
What exactly are we celebrating?
We're celebrating the fact that Kurt and I have the camp double wrapped up. No more doubt about it, man. Olympics, here we come! Woo! So good! We did it, man. You and me, we are going to the Olympics.
Okay, boys, listen up. Everyone gather around the table. We've got a couple of important announcements to make. Bouscaren, Cruz, you guys are gonna row the camp double. For the quad, Danny, you're gonna be the stroke.
Yes!
The rest of the quad will be chosen by the end of the week. Just one more announcement. Following rowers have been cut from the camp. Paul Enquist, Sean Patterson, Martin Klein, Ronald Reagan, and George Bush.
Where's Mr. Parker? He should be here to tell us this himself. I think I really need to talk to him.
I'm up here, Paul.
I don't really blame you for cutting me. I know I haven't been rowing very well this whole time. I understand your choice and your position. I'd make the same. But I want you to know, in a couple of days, my arm is gonna be better. So when I leave here, I'm gonna get myself a skull, and I'm gonna put together the fastest team you've ever seen. So come Carnegie, I'm gonna row through every boat on the water. Mark my words, sir. I'm gonna make you proud, sir.
Sure you will, Paul.
I got the Harry Parker blues. I came to his camp with no intention to lose. Yeah, but then he took his whistle and he shoved it up my ass. He said, son, you can't row worth a goddamn blade of grass. Yeah.
Harry thinks what you need most is patience. I think he's gonna pair you and Tiff for the second double. Soon.
He had his chance. Tiff and I should have been the first double.
Harry, I'd put you with Tiff right away. Maybe you'd be the one with your arm in a sling. Shit, you guys together, it probably would have been worse than a pulled muscle. You're so fucking aggressive.
Did Parker sell this shit, or are you just making it up as you go along?
You know, Harry is not the most verbal guy around. You kind of have to use your imagination with him and figure out the meaning of what he's not saying.
Yeah, you could be right, but it's now or never.
Wait up! Polar bear. Come on, man. Wait up. Polar bear.
Mr. Parker! Mr. Parker, I'm talking to you. I'll give you one more chance. I mean it, Parker. You hear me? Are you gonna pair Tiff and me for the second double?
You know the answer to that, Polar bear.
Okay, I got you. Tiff, wanna leave the camp with me and roll a challenge double? Come on, man.
Doesn't sound like a very practical solution to me, Polar Bear.
You're probably right. Thank you, Mr. Parker.
Nothing's right this year. I mean, you pray all your career for a rower of Tiff's caliber to come along and then, or a Biglow, Bouscaren, a Nelson. And then they all come along the same year and they tear each other apart.
So what, Harry?
Hmm?
So, a great rower. Maybe the greatest rower. Is going to miss out on the Olympics 2 times running?
You got any suggestions?
Yeah.
Now may I row the double with Tiff?
Thank you.
Mr. Parker, what rate are we supposed to be rowing at?
Damn it, Cruz, this is a race, not some paddle in the park! Now put some muscle into it if you've got any!
Look at the slaughter of those guys.
Hey, what's going on here, Joe?
What's going on here?
Yeah.
As if it wasn't clear, man. There are 7 spots in this squad, Biggie, and you already have one. Now you're gonna take mine? Screw that.
Say, nobody's trying to take your spot, Joe.
No! We've been teammates for 6 years, and now you're gonna blow both our chances.
Hey, wait a second. Nobody's trying to blow anybody's chances here. Would you hold up for a second? Hey! But what about Tiff Wood? He's worked harder and longer than anybody else here. Don't you think he deserves a chance? He's not gonna get it in a single.
You know what? I am really sorry that things didn't work out for Tiff, but he had his chance. This is our year, man, you and me. This is what we've always dreamed about, man, going to the Olympics.
Hey, hold up, what, Joe? First of all, I think you're taking this a little bit more personally than you need to. Think about it. There's 3 of us. There's gotta be a way for all 3 of us to go. Come on, you're the 3rd best sculler in the United States, Joe, and Tiff would-
Fuck Tiff! And fuck you too, man! You know what, John? You fucked with the system. And you fucked up our friendship forever. Nice knowing you, Biggie.
Hey, forgot your little hat.
Keep it. Remind you what could have been.
This shit before it destroys the camp.
Damn it!
All right, let's talk about this. Now, what is going on with you two?
They're in there talking about how Enquist is gonna run a challenge double.
So?
So I'll bet you he'll have a really powerful team.
So what? You wanna quit? Huh? I do not like that attitude, Joe. That is what is going to hold you back, that attitude.
I don't like your attitude, sir.
What did you say, Cruz? What did you say?
I said I don't like your attitude. I mean, you're not even committed to your own goddamn camp. It's like all you ever wanted was for Tiff to win the single. And well, hell, now that he hasn't, you're just gonna shoehorn your boy into the Olympics any way you can. And it's bullshit, Mr. Parker.
You were sloppy on your finish. We need to clean that up.
Let's try something new tomorrow. Biggie, you set the stroke.
Good.
Okay, but you should adjust your collars then.
Okay, I'll have to shorten my stroke too, because my reach is longer than yours.
Even it takes longer.
Bauer's funny that way.
Competition between the 2 doubles is history.
What are you talking about?
He's calling it off.
So why not?
You lost 3 1,000 meter sets today. That's why not.
Always by a fraction of a second, Harry.
Yeah, and we know what to do to fix that.
Made my decision. You're going back to training for the single, Biglow.
That's not fair, Harry. You encouraged us.
Come on, Biggie, let him talk to Tip by himself. Let's get out of here.
I'll stroke tomorrow, Tiff.
You know I can't row the quad. Never be able to adjust to Danny's stroke.
I know.
I'm stronger in the double than Bouscaren. At the very least, let me seat race against him. Me with Cruz. Biggie with Bouscaren.
A bit late for that, Tiff.
Fuck it, Harry! Why haven't you paired me with any of the stronger rowers?
You wanted me to put you with Polar Bear!
Yeah, Polar Bear, to name just one!
You weren't ready for him!
ready for him. You weren't ready for any of us!
You guys are not rowing the double anymore. You can put that back in the boathouse.
Hey, you know what? You guys have to stop acting like this. You're acting like a couple of brats.
Hey, Bouscaren, stay under this, all right, man? I said you guys are not rowing the double anymore. Put it back in the boathouse.
What the hell are you doing?
Back off, Danny. I'm talking to you guys. Biglow Wood. Out of the water,
hey,
now.
This is our boat.
Back off, Bouscaren. All of you guys. Out of there now.
Guys, you're ruining everything. You're destroying the camp system.
Fuck the system. The system's on strike.
All right, guys, move in. Move in!
Adam, get these rowers organized. We've got a long day ahead of us.
Come on, boys, let's move up.
Seven strokes per minute slower, and we're walking right through them, and they don't even understand what's happening. It's gonna be beautiful. I don't think Parker's gonna stand in the way. He wants to win as badly as we do.
Biglow, are you prepared to give up your title to the singles?
Well, I don't know, Mr. Harry. I thought I'd wait on that decision until after the doubles trial was over.
Well, I don't think you can do that.
Who says?
I do. Tiff, you have an alternative. You can row spare for the quad.
I'm leaving the camp, Harry. I'm gonna row a challenge double.
Well, fine. You go ahead. You do that. Where are you gonna find a partner?
I'll find what I need. It was fun while it lasted.
Right. Now, you're not going to leave your gear. You're not going to leave your gear here like Polar Bear did, are you?
It's in the car. I packed it this morning.
Ah.
Thank you.
For what?
For allowing our brief rebellion. Coming with me?
My book is about rowing. It's about you and Parker and Biggie and everybody else. It's about this tight little society of open hunger and secret
pain.
Okay. It is about you. But not only you. New partner yet?
Jungle drums are loud tonight. Said I was looking.
Who do you think?
Kate?
She really cares for you, you know. Go and don't come back.
Why? What we have has always been so easy.
So, and be easy too.
I have no life or death. I make the ties of breathing my life and death. I have no body. I make endurance my body. I have no eye. I make the path of lightning my eye. I have no mirror.
You quit the camp?
Yeah.
You have any plans?
You found a new partner yet?
Not yet.
You ready to row?
When?
getting myself a new partner, someone human, for a change. I tried. Okay? I really tried. Really tried.
Hey.
Gonna go after him?
No. He does this kind of thing every 3 hours.
It's a little late in the day for theatrics, isn't it? The trials are, what, 72 hours away? Hey.
Polar Bear came back an hour later. All told, they got in 20 hours of practice together, and they'd been going up against guys who'd been rowing together for weeks. They knew the odds were dead against them, but, you know, Tiff and Polar Bear, they had to be there.
Ha! 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 Ha!
Are we ready to destroy the enemy?
Are we ready to destroy the enemy?
We're gonna pound the fucking shit out of them! Ha! 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 Ha!
Look, Joe, you've just gotta remember to keep your slides slow and your hands fast, otherwise you're gonna fuck us for the sprint, okay?
Listen, Cruz, why don't you stop dumping on me, okay?
Hey, you guys.
I know
you boys about
how to
ready
stall,
to row.
Okay? Why don't you get dressed and get ready to row, all right?
Why don't you save some of that anger for the doors?
Listen, I stayed up all night last night finishing this, so I don't want to hear any bullshit about it. It was a little something like this.
Hammering the water, Tiff. That's not rowing, that's killing fish.
10 minutes till right time. Ladies and gentlemen, please clear the starting area.
Gentlemen, to your starting positions, please.
Hey, guys, good luck. I said good luck.
Hey, give it up, Cruz. It's not worth it.
The 1984 training camp was the worst nightmare of Harry's coaching career. The only year his mastery didn't make the magic. John Biglow went to the Olympics, and he fought like hell there, but he didn't medal. His partner won the trials and rode their challenge double right through to the Olympics. They won the gold. Paul told me later that when he was standing on the winner's box, he saw Harry Parker joyfully waving his hands. Hard to imagine Harry waving, let alone joyfully. Maybe at the Olympics. But the irony is, what rowers are still talking about is the dead heat at the trials between Bouscaren and Cruz and Tiff and Polar Bear. None of these guys went to the Olympics, but that final showdown has become the stuff of legend.
Hard to see!
victory. Come on, repeat after me. Born in sin, baptized in blood, crowned in victory.
Still rowing the double in your head.
I was rowing the single. And when I lost to Biggie, the sinful thing about that was, at the end of the race, I still had energy to burn. But today, when I went all out, I burned it all out of me.